On any given day in the city, you'll come across unexpected obstacles. Potholes, train tracks, curbs, grates, even the occasional loose dog. The Redux One can handle it all. Inspired by mountain bike design, it's our urban street bike that gets you around, over, or through anything you'll encounter. This bike comes with a single ring up front and 8 gears in the back for smooth shifting and low maintenance. The Redux One rolls on extra-wide WTB Horizon tires, which give you the versatility to ride on both pavement and gravel. An aluminum blade fork with internal cable routing gives the bike a clean look. The wide bar with 15 millimeters of rise gives you better stability, handling, and comfort, so even on long rides, you'll feel unflappable. Tektro mechanical disc brakes allow for easy maintenance and provide great stopping power in wet and dirty conditions. Best of all, the Redux One comes shipped ready ride, so it's 95% assembled right out of the box. Make easy work of any obstacle the city throws at you on the Redux One.
For purchasing a Raleigh bike. As you open the box, you'll see there is some assembly required. If you have never built a bike before, this process will probably take you up to 120 minutes. If you are handy with tools, expect to spend around 80 to 100 minutes. If you have done some bike wrenching before but never actually built a bike, you'll need 60 to 80 minutes. And if you're an expert bike mechanic, you can probably be riding within 30 to 60 minutes. Grab the box containing the small parts and keep these parts handy. You'll need a few tools for assembly, including metric Allen wrenches, bike grease, a tire pump, screwdrivers, wire cutters, and an adjustable wrench. Before you insert the seat post, smear some grease on the post to make installation and adjustments easier, and make sure you push it past the minimum insertion line. Close the quick release or tighten the seat post clamp bolt. You'll know your seat post is tight enough if you can't twist it side to side. Check that your stem is facing forward along with your fork. You may need to turn your fork forward to line them both up. Tighten the two pinch bolts evenly. The wrench should leave an imprint on your palm when it's tight enough. Remove the faceplate bolts and the faceplate, then center your handlebars. Tighten the bolts evenly and snugly, then check to make sure you have an equal gap on the top and bottom. To install the wheels, take the plastic caps off the wheel and loosen the bolts enough that you can fit the axle into the dropouts of the fork. Now tighten the bolts evenly by hand until they are snug. Then fully tighten them with your wrench. You'll know the bolts are tight enough when the wrench leaves an imprint on your palm. If your bike has quick-release axles, remove the plastic caps from your front wheel and slide the quick-release through the hub with one conical spring on each side. Grease the threads and thread the nut on loosely. Put the fork wheel in the fork, and if the brake caliper is already installed, carefully guide the rotor in between the brake pads, then begin to tighten the quick release. When you close the lever, it should tuck up near the fork leg, and when it's tight enough, the lever will leave an imprint on your palm. If your bike has a through axle, it's probably already installed in the fork. Take it out and place the front wheel in the fork. If the brake caliper is already attached, carefully guide the brake rotor between the brake pads. If your through axle has threads, grease them, push it through the fork and the hub, and turn clockwise to tighten it. When you close the lever, it should leave an imprint on your palm when it's tight enough. After you get your front wheel on, check the back wheel for proper tightness too. All pedals are right and left specific, so be careful as to which pedal goes where. Use a small dab of grease on the threads. The right pedal goes on the side with the chain and threads in clockwise. The left pedal goes on the non-chain side and threads in counterclockwise. Snug your pedals with a pedal wrench or a thin adjustable wrench. For mechanical disc brakes, attach the caliper body loosely to the fork if it's not already on. With the wheel secured, run the cable from the brake arm through the cable housing and through the pinch bolt. Pull the cable taut and tighten the pinch bolt. Next, align the caliper body by hand, visually centering the rotor in between the brake pads. When you can see a gap on both sides of the rotor, tighten the bolts holding the caliper body to the frame. Spin the wheel to test the system, and if there is any rubbing, make adjustments using the bolts you just tightened and adjust as necessary. To adjust your rear derailleur, turn the cranks and shift the chain to the smallest cog in the back. Use the high limit screw to center the derailleur underneath the smallest cog. Undo the pinch bolt and pull the slack out of the cable. While turning the cranks, shift up into the lowest gear. Now you can use the low limit screw to center the derailleur underneath the largest cog. To adjust your front derailleur, shift into the smallest chain ring in the front and the largest cog in the back. Use the low limit screw to position the inner plate as close as you can to the chain without touching it. Loosen the pinch bolt to pull the slack out of the cable and retighten. While turning the cranks, shift up into the largest chainring in the front and the smallest cog in the back. Now you can use the high limit screw to position the outer plate of the derailleur as close to the chain as you can without touching it. Put the red reflector on the seat post and the white one on your handlebars. Safety first! Cut any extra cable down with your cutters and pinch a cable end on with your pliers to keep the cable from fraying. Finally, pump your tires following the guidelines on the sidewall of the tire. Before you head out on a ride, double check the tightness of your seat post and handlebars and test the brakes to make sure they'll stop you when you need them.
Hi there, welcome to the Gama family. I'm Michelle, and I'm here to teach you how to assemble your bike. Because you might have thought that you were gonna receive something like this, but instead, your bike came out like this. We recommend you taking your bicycle to be assembled by a professional. However, if you wanna build it yourself, this is how to do it. So the first step is to open the box. Cut open the box and take out all the parts. In the accessory box, you'll find tools, seat post, saddle, pedals, accessories, bell, basket brackets, and your manual. Now put everything in your basket so you don't lose it. Turn the fork to make the brake facing forward. then cleaned the wrappings and removed all parts that were attached to the bike. Insert the fork into the box so it is stable for the next steps. Untangle the handlebars from the frame. Loosen the bolt on the stem of the handlebar. Place the handlebar stem into the frame and pre-secure it by tightening the bolt a little bit. Now loosen the bolt around the handlebar and rotate the handles up so that they're about parallel with the floor. Depending on the bike that you purchased, you might get a seat post with a bracket or without a bracket. The seat post without the bracket is installed by inserting the post into the bottom of the seat. Tighten the seat slightly with a wrench. For this tube, loosen the bolt, rotate the bracket, and insert the rails of the saddle in it. Then secure the bolt again. To install the seat in your bike, open the quick release, tighten the bolt, insert the tube, and secure the quick release. Now, you can remove the fork from the box, discard it, and turn your bike upside down. To install the front fender, first, undo the noodle of your front brake. Then unscrew this nut with the wrench and insert the fender's bracket and secure the nut. Remove these bolts from the tip of the fork and use them to secure the legs of the fender. Finally, make sure that all bolts are tight on the fork. Depending on the bike you purchased, you will get one of these two wheels. One comes with a nut, and the other with a quick release. To install the wheel, loosen the nuts on both sides of the axle without taking them out and insert it onto the fork. Your wheel has a specific direction. Make sure it is turning the right way. Secure the wheel by screwing the nuts back in. Just make sure that the safety hook is correctly inserted in the hole. Make sure the wheel is well centered in the fork, and make a final tightening with the wrench. The other wheel is a bit different. First, check the direction before placing it on the fork. Remove the plastic nut as well as the spring from the quick release. Then insert the quick release into the side that is opposite off the chain. When it's done, place the spring this way and screw in the plastic nut. The final step is to make sure that the wheel is centered and secure the quick release. The pedals are marked for their respective sides, with an L for left and an R for right. Just so you know, the right side of the bike is the side with the chain and the chain guard. You can screw it in first with your hand and make a final tightening with the wrench. Now the basic assembly of your bike is complete, let's move to adjustments. Let's adjust the brakes now. First, you have to unscrew the pads and position them correctly. The curved part should be facing up so they go with the shape of the rims. Make sure the pads don't touch the tires and make a final tightening to secure them. Now, connect the noodle back. The next step is to adjust the travel of your brake cable. Here, it's too long. First, unscrew the adjustment barrel without taking it out. Then, release the cable of the brake by unscrewing the nut here. Squeeze the brake arms with your hands, making the pads touch the rims, and secure the cable back. This will make your brake chew tight. To make it right, just screw the adjustment barrel back in completely. We're almost done. Last step is to adjust the tension. Both arms need to touch the rims at the same time. For this, screw the little bolts at the bottom of the brakes to determine which arms need adjustments. Remember to check your back brake as well. When it's done, just spin the wheel. If it's not touching the rims, you're all set. To adjust your seat, untighten the bracket and position your seat so it's parallel to the ground. Then secure it back. For the seat with bracket, untighten the bolt under the seat and position it into the correct position and retighten the same bolt. For the height adjustment, always respect the insertion limit marked by this line. To know the right height, just sit on your bike. The correct height is when your leg is almost straight, when your foot is positioned on the pedal at its lowest point. Now, let's adjust the angle of your handlebar. Loosen the bolt of your handlebar and position it parallel to the ground. For the adjustable stem, loosen the bolt on the bottom and the one on the side. Adjust to a comfortable angle and tighten all bolts as much as possible. It's very important to tighten these bolts in the correct way. Then to adjust the angle of your handlebar, loosen the bolts on the head of the stem and retighten equally after positioning it parallel to the ground. For the stem height, loosen the bolt at the stem and position your handlebar in a comfortable height without passing the insertion limit. For the brake levers, you need to position them so that they are aligned with your arms. Before you install your basket, make sure your brakes are completely adjusted. Install the legs of the basket on the tip of the fork. Make sure the cables stay free. This bracket will attach to the back of your basket. While these will secure the bottom of your basket. The flat one goes inside the basket. The bent one goes face up and locks the arm to your basket. Lastly, screw all bolts and make sure that they are tight. Your reflector brackets come in two sizes. The one with the smaller hole goes with the white reflector. The bracket with the larger hole goes with the red reflector. Install the red reflector on the seat tube. And install the white reflector on the handlebar. The bell goes on the left side of your handlebar. If your bell doesn't ring, simply adjust the position so the arm is well aligned to hit the bell. Don't forget the safety caps. There's one for every hub nut. If your bike doesn't stand by itself, just bend the kickstand a little by putting your weight on the bike like this. And you're done!